I thought this movie was interesting for a while, but, you know, it just kept dragging on and on. In a horror movie, you want to see kills, and if the movie's just interesting, it's not enough, because there are horror movies that I really enjoy where the kills happen like an hour in, but you don't notice it because the movie's entertaining. But this movie, it was just kind of unique. You're paying attention to the characters, but you do really want to see kills, and then when it finally happens, they're pretty fucking good. But I was not a big fan of this movie. I don't even know how to describe it. I'm pretty sure a lot of people like this movie, but I did not enjoy it. A girl goes on a trip with her boyfriend that's been planning to break up with her for like a year with his, three buddies. And one of them is actually a bad guy in a cult or whatever, and this was his plan all along or some shit. The other guy's just kind of disrespectful. He ends up pissing on a tree that they keep their people's ashes in, and then he gets killed. And then this other guy gets, like, his head bashed in. Also, most of the kills in this movie aren't even violent. It's just more of, like, the shock value of what you see their corpses later. Because they, like, make them look all crazy. Like, oh, this guy's got his lungs ripped out, and but they're still breathing, and he's got, like, flowers in his eyes. I mean, it's cool when you first see it, but it's honestly not enough. It's just kind of dumb. Like, you shouldn't do all of your kills like that. There's only two kills, and they were done by themselves. I mean, there's some kills later in the movie that aren't like that, that are on screen, but it's, like, at the very end of the movie. They basically rape the shitty character. Not even basically, they do. He was an asshole, like, the entire movie. Clearly didn't care about his girlfriend's feelings at all. And pushes the blame on her when she's just trying to have a civil conversation with her. But, you know, later in the movie, he gets put with a love potion or shit, drugged. Drinks literal period blood for, like, the love potion or shit, and ends up getting drugged again before he even goes in there. And is basically, you know, drugged out of his mind and forced to have sex with this girl. And they have, like, a bunch of random chicks around, completely naked too, and fucking, there's another girl behind him pushing him on the butt deeper, I guess is what she's trying to do. It's very long and not necessary. They do give you a break for a little bit and cut to something different. But they go right back to it. He ends up leaving, like, full naked with his dick out. You know, he's obviously didn't want to do that, drugged out of his mind, kind of felt forced to do that. But he gets a pretty fucking bad death, which is terrifying. He gets paralyzed and he's unable to speak, and then they put him in a bear that we saw earlier in one scene of the movie. They killed it off screen, and now they put him inside of the bear, and now they're calling him a beast and burning him alive or some shit, because she thought he was cheating on her, when I guess technically he was, but it was a rape. It's kind of confusing, but there's no way you can't say it's not rape, because he was drugged multiple times on top of a love potion and, like, the weird period blood shit. There's all kinds of weird shit. Like, it's just so weird. But then, you know, it ends with her smiling, so I guess she's joined the cult or whatever. I did not like this movie. It started off pretty interesting, but I could care less for it. It was way too long. Took way too long to go anywhere, in my opinion. I've watched slow-burning movies before, and I've liked them. This is not one of them.